timeframe or the time timeframe for the other players, you said?
But initially, I was disappointed at the phone call that he didn't arrive at the airport. He didn't want to fight. So I was disappointed, but, you know, what can I do? I turned up Madrid to fight the guy I wanted for a long time. He hasn't turned up. So I'm just going to be focused now on a new opponent. Same fight night, and yeah, I'm just looking forward to getting my hands on the belt.
You said there in the press conference that you won't call yourself world champion until definitely.
Yeah.
Is that a psychological thing?
Yeah, partly, yeah. And I think because I know I've got business to do first on Saturday, but still a fighting group, I've still got to win. And it's a dangerous opponent next time. I've still got business to do, and I'll make sure that I'll get business done first before I can say Germany and I feel like the champ and achieve my dream and the celebration of the dream.
Your thoughts on Tony Bellion? I suppose in one step you're happy that he has stepped in and saved the show. Well, another thought, you don't obviously like him. But, you said he's dead in his feet. You think the fight might be over early?
Could be. And you know, he believes he's got the type of power to get me out early, to KO me. So it's interesting, and I believe that. I think if someone could get knocked out as well, it could be Tony Bellew. I think this is one of those fights that could go either way, but I genuinely believe that I can knock Tony Bellew out. And he's been saying for 2 years now that he's steadied me and he's going to do this to me and beat me and kill me. But the fight this year is finally here, and this is the time to prove it, and we're both up for it. And we're both going to prove a point.
It is amazing how things work. When I seen you fighting Bremer, I thought the same as Tony said. So I thought you would actually outbox him. And I didn't really like him as an opponent, you know. And then all of a sudden, 3 days to go, Tony Bellion comes in. And someone said that you've outdone the Gale and Groves thing in a matter of one press conference.
Yeah, well,
it's fantastic.
Yeah, it is. It's a great fight. It's a rivalry, a grudge. Yeah, it's a British fight for a world title. It definitely creates more of an interest than myself and Jürgen Bremer, I think. So it's a bonus for the fans. It's a fight that Tony wanted. It's a fight that I want. And we're here, we're ready.
I know boxers don't like to look past the fight in front of them, but taking Dukon fight, I presume one of your first times would be to defend that title in your hometown, something you've been waiting for a long time.
Yeah, that would be ideal, but that's more. I start thinking about that long term, really. Because short term, I've got business to do Saturday and win first. And I win. I've got my hands on that belt, I'm world champion, and obviously I can go for the big homecoming then.
And I want to finish off by saying you have a lot of similarities to Joe Calzaghe, and your dad's a lot of similarities to him as well. And the one thing I always felt reporting on boxing, Enzo never really got any credit for Joe's progress.
Yeah.
My dad's in the same boat. Saturday night, if you win the title, he's going to be a trainer, a world champion. Fantastic achievement. But yet, you don't. Do you think he gets the credit that he's owed?
I suppose not, really. That's just the way it works. I know Enzo Calzaghe and Joe, it took a while for them to be established. Same with my dad and myself, but you know, it's important that you just get the victories, and by doing that, the accolades will come. It's just important that you keep winning. That's the number one, and you keep winning, and everything will fall into place.
Well, I wish you the best of luck for Saturday night. I hope you win the world title.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.